Hey guys, today I'll be talking to you about the pros and cons of selling your fashion line, wholesale versus retail, and what you can expect. So let's start with retail. A pro about selling your retail would be you can sell your product directly to your consumer, whether that be online or at a brick and mortar, but your product can go directly to your consumer and you don't have to go through a middleman. Another good thing about that is you can sell it at the price that you choose to sell your garments at. Now, there is a formula that you can use to calculate the rate to decide on what rate you should use for your products, to sell your products at, but you don't necessarily have to use that rate. You can use whatever formula you choose and decide to sell it at whatever you want or whatever you think your garments are worth. Now, that formula that most retailers use is recommended, but it's your choice. I will say one thing about selling online is you can cut out a lot of costs versus selling at a brick and mortar. You can cut your overhead fees. It's very inexpensive to sell online because when you have a brick and mortar store, you have to pay a large overhead fee. Like you have to pay rent, you have to pay electricity, and it's a lot of things that come with having a brick and mortar store. But you can start online and cut your costs by using platforms such as Shopify, GoDaddy, or Bluehost. Now you do have fees to pay, but they're very small fees, small monthly fees compared to what you have to pay if you open up a brick and mortar. So that's something you can think about. And people love the convenience of shopping online. So if you do open your online shop, you know, you grow your audience, you grow your business online, and then after a few years, you can open up a brick and mortar when people know who you are. So definitely keep that in mind, starting online and then eventually growing. Now let's talk about some cons of, you know, having your business online or even having a brick and mortar. You have to market your business when you're selling direct to consumer. You have to market like crazy because you can't expect that if you open a store, if you make a product and put it online, that people are gonna come to your website or people are gonna come to your store. That's not the case. You have to have a following. People have to know who you are. They have to be engaged. You have to be, you know, known on social media, because if not, you have to market like crazy through social media, through ads, through promotions, and of course you have to be your own brand ambassador and market it yourself through networking events and, you know, being the face of your brand. So that's something to decide on when, you know, selling your line directly to consumer. Okay, now let's talk about some tips of selling your line wholesale, some of the pros and cons. Let's start with the pros. Selling your line wholesale to a specialty boutique would mean you get your money up front, versus online, you don't have to wait for somebody to go and buy your product. If you sell to a specialty boutique, you get your money up front. Another good thing is you can build brand recognition. People will know who you are because you can get the clientele of the boutique. You can have them buy your line and then they know who you are, so they're more likely to research you if they like your clothing. Also, another good thing is you get immediate customer feedback. So those clients are gonna tell the boutique owner and the salespeople how they like your product, how it fits, what they like about it, what they don't like about it, things of that nature. So immediate customer feedback is very important because that's how you build your target audience, and that makes you a better designer. So when you're getting this customer feedback, you know how you should design for your next season because you know what your customers want and you know what they don't want. So that's a really good thing about selling your line wholesale. Also, you can educate the salespeople on how they should sell your line. No one knows your line better than you. So you can educate those salespeople about what they should tell the clients when they come into the store, like the uniqueness of your brand, how you designed it, maybe the fabric, and that's also gonna help your line sell. Let's talk about the cons. One of the cons would be is you can't sell your line for as much as you would retail. So when you sell wholesale, it's almost like you have to cut your cost in half and sell it for half the price that you would retail. And so you don't get as much money or make as much of a profit selling wholesale as you would retail. Another thing would be delayed payments. Sometimes these specialty boutiques don't always pay on time. So that's a con when it comes down to selling wholesale. So you really just have to evaluate your brand and your goals of your brand and what you want to do and where you see yourself in the future and decide whether you want to sell it wholesale versus retail. Now you can take these tips that I've provided and hopefully you're designing your line right now. You're trying to decide on what you should do and it can be very overwhelming. Trust me, I know. But when you do decide, just make sure you do the right thing for your brand. What's your brand gonna fit? Of course, you can think, hey, I'll make more money selling retail, you know, directly to my consumers. But think about all the marketing that you have to do versus starting off selling wholesale, you know, building up your clientele, building up your brand recognition, and then eventually taking your business online. So it's up to you guys, but whatever you decide, good luck. I'm sure you'll do well. I enjoy making this video for you, and I hope to see you next time. Make sure you hit that subscribe button because I'll be putting out more great content in another video next week. Bye-bye.